This next video is about how you connect the camera to the flash so you can synchronize the moment that you press the button and the camera takes a picture to the moment that the flash fires, because they need to be in sync, because it all happens in a fraction of a second. The simplest way to do it is with this cable here. It's called a PC flash cord, and it's a really, really handy cable. And I like this one just because it's so simple, because you're quite obviously connected from the flash to the camera. You can also do it through wireless, and I'll show you that one in the next video. So the first step, it kind of looks like a headphone jack, but the only difference is it only has one sort of black ring on it. It's a headphone jack, but it has more than one ring. But the other end kind of looks like that, and it just has a little pin inside. So basically you start off with plugging it into what kind of looks like a headphone jack over here. And the other part is goes on top. This is called the hot shoe of the camera. This is called the Nikon AS-15 unit. It's right there. It's very small. And you just plug it in to the terminal right here. So that's it so far. So in terms of our camera settings, we always need to work on manual in the studio, so you have full control over aperture and shutter speed. So we're on manual right now. And we also want to just make sure our ISO is really low. And right now the ISO is at 200, which is good. All right, so the next thing is we need a shutter speed. And typically the shutter speed you use is basically 100 or 125th of a second. You can go a little faster, but it won't actually make any difference. So basically put it at 100th of a second. The only thing that really matters is your aperture. So your aperture is typically going to be somewhere in the range of f8 to f16. Now it depends on the brightness of the flash. But basically once you have the aperture about where you need it, you'll take a test picture and look at the result. If it's too bright, then you adjust. If it's too dark, you adjust as well. But now that we have everything connected, the flash should fire. So let's just, if I can take a picture of the keyboard right there, really high quality award-winning picture. But with any luck, it will synchronize and we'll get a flash. And that time the exposure was good. So that's how you connect the flash to the camera with the hot shoe. You plug it in.